So iENGAGE was a randomized controlled trial focusing on persons newly entering HIV medical care at four different cities across the U.S. So Seattle, Washington, Birmingham, Alabama, Chapel Hill, North Carolina, and Baltimore, Maryland. And we wanted to focus on the new-to-care population because a lot of challenges when folks first enter care adjusting to a new HIV diagnosis while being challenged with coming to regular medical visits, starting medicines to have a high degree of adherence. So this idea of could we transform this vulnerable time into a teachable moment and through the intervention help folks coming into care acquire the skills for coming to visits and adhering to medications to achieve viral suppression simultaneous to supporting them through this adjustment process of now living with HIV. Historically, what we found was that in the late 2000s, 60% of persons newly entering HIV medical care achieved viral suppression at 48 weeks. And it took on the order of 9 months for those folks to achieve viral suppression. And I think what we saw in the trial was that the treatment landscape had changed dramatically from the late 2000s. We enrolled from 2013 to 16, and with those changes, viral suppression was achieved in a median of 63 days by 85% of participants in both the intervention and the control arm. I think part of why we saw 60% historically and then 85% in both groups during the study period is practice outpaced science, so that the combination of guidelines for earlier therapy, the cascade focus and emphasis now with these rapid start programs, as well as the emergence of well-tolerated single-tablet regimens, and including integrated strand inhibitors, really changed the practice landscape from that 60% suppression in 2009 to 2010 to the 85% that we saw from 2013 to 2016. I think for providers, probably one of the big take-home messages in well-resourced Ryan White clinics, even among a group of patients that have a high burden of depression, anxiety, perceived stigma, unmet needs for housing, transportation, food insecurity, and up to 50%, that with the right resources, it's very much achievable to achieve viral suppression for everyone, for all groups entering care.